Thank you so much for joining us today on Weather Center Live. I'm Kate Parker.
And I'm Bonnie Schneider. It's one of the last things people in the plains want to hear. But there is more flooding on the way.
Yeah, this is a really big deal. Flooding on the way, severe weather along with it. 1,000 miles of severe weather. It's more than 60 million that are on alert. We're going to break down the timing of the storms that stretch from the Midwest to the Mid-Atlantic, plus all how it ties into the Ring of Fire.
Well, that'll be very interesting.
A surge of tropical moisture from the Gulf of Mexico going to make for a very wet week for North Texas. And this region, you know, I've been there endlessly lately, you know, flying there for flooding because it is so saturated.
Just when they thought they were getting a break. Unfortunately, these rains will be fuel for the heavy storms straight through the week. And our own Chris Warren is live in Dallas for us, bracing for what's ever headed from Invest 91L. Chris, how is it there now? It looks kind of dark behind you.
I was noticing you're there on the Trinity River. And when I was there a couple weeks ago, the water was up actually above that stop sign. It looks like it's gone down a little, already falling in places. We've got hurricane specialist Michael Lowry with us because the hurricane hunters flying through this right now is investigating the invest.
Yeah, I really get excited when the hurricane hunters go out there because we just don't have any observations to tell us whether or not this is a tropical depression or it is a tropical storm until the plane gets out there. So they took off from Keesler Air Force Base in Biloxi, Kate, around 5:30 this morning, and they've been in there for several hours now and still haven't found that defined circulation. There is a circulation, but it's really broad right now. There's this broad turning of the winds, and what you look for is a really circular area of winds, and we're just not seeing those very strong winds on the west, or out of the west, on the south side of it, just quite yet. And that's why this isn't a tropical depression or a tropical storm. But nonetheless, a lot of rainfall with it.
Right. Huge, broad areas. Would there be a benefit to getting that closed circulation? Would we actually see a positive if we could form this into a depression instead of just being this huge swath of moisture?
No, I think at this point, it's just too close to land to have any positive effects from getting a closed circulation. If anything, it might get a little bit stronger, which we don't want for folks there. With a tighter circulation, though, you could see the impacts closer to where the circulation is and less spread out. That would be a good thing, but it's just too
late for that.
Too late for that. Yeah.
So there are a lot of things that are inhibiting this, right, from developing. Maybe they're not finding that circulation for a reason.
Yeah, and there's I want to talk about this really, really quickly because there's an instrument on the bottom of the plane that is actually looking down on the ocean surface, and this is how they're estimating the wind in the hurricane. I think it's just fascinating that they're actually measuring the radiation that's coming up from the sea foam on the ocean surface to determine what the winds are. But yeah, they're really at this point not looking at how strong the winds are. They're looking at that, but they're really interested in whether or not the winds are really coming all the way around in a well-defined circulation. And it doesn't look like we're going to get a tropical depression or tropical storm at 11 a.m., which is when they generally put out their advisories. So not there just yet, but if you look on the water vapor picture, there is just an incredible amount of moisture here in the Gulf of Mexico. That upper level low that was helping to really stifle the development of this, mm-hmm. starting to weaken because you're getting convection near the center. That is weakening that upper low mm-hmm. from the top down. So the atmosphere is becoming a little more favorable.
Okay, so we could see this develop, but regardless, what does this mean? What is the drive home point?
The drive home point, big, significant rainfall threat for southeast Texas and southwestern Louisiana over the next 2 days.
Okay.
Yeah.
You heard it here. Time to get ready.
This on Weather Center Live, I'm Bonnie Schneider.
And I'm Kate Parker. We have been incredibly busy across the world, not just here in our country with flooding, in China, obviously now in Georgia, and now we've got us up next. Again, big problems, heavy rain, Texas, Louisiana, as far north as Illinois and Michigan.
Yeah, this is a widespread area for sure. And
the next couple days is going to get pretty interesting there, Dave, because this surge of tropical moisture in the Gulf, it's going to make for a very wet week and a dangerous week, not just from San Antonio, but going right up into North Texas. Now that area is completely saturated. The rain in May was incredible, record rain for Dallas. We're going to be talking about fuel for heavy storms this week with all that tropical moisture just adding to the problem. Our Chris Warren live in Dallas for us. Now the DFW Metroplex, the Trinity River that's behind you, it runs right through it. This is a major metroplex with millions of people that live in it. Floodplains are in place for the Trinity River, but all the tributaries, everything that goes into it, that's another problem, right, Chris?